Thank you. I know. Just a little while longer and I'll know you. Just a little while longer. Sure. Spirit of God. Presence in this place. Thank you for your presence, that you give us access to your presence. Jesus, we thank you that you are worth it all, and that there is no cost too high, no cost too high to know you, to follow you, Lord. We love you and we love your presence. In Jesus' name, amen. At this time, we will transition into a time of intercession for the nation of Israel. Today, we will pray through the names given to Israel by God in Isaiah 62. I encourage you to open your Bibles to Isaiah 62 as we pray. And I invite you to come into agreement with me as I pray and follow by lifting up your own intercession. Lord, we thank you for the new name you have given Israel. And you call her Hephzibah, for she is your pure delight. And we thank you that her destiny is not of hiddenness or desolation, but of righteousness going forth as brightness. We declare that Israel is the object of your affection, God, and we pray for Israel to become aware of your pleasure over her, that this revelation would continue to awaken and move hearts. We ask, O God, that your goodness toward Israel would be made known, and we pray for Jerusalem to become a praise in the earth, not an object of scorn or hatred. Give believers around the world a heart to support Israel in a way that is only explainable by a supernatural transfer of your heart and your delight. Would you establish Israel in her identity as your inheritance, as a crown of beauty and a royal diadem? You are proud to call her your own, and you are proud of the one that you handpicked from the beginning of time. Jesus, you died to have her back, and Hephzibah is always at the forefront of your mind. Make this reality known to them, Lord. Let's pray. thank you that you call Israel Beulah. You call her land married, not abandoned, not unwanted or unoccupied, but married. We come into agreement with what you call her, and we declare favor, blessing, and fruitfulness upon the land that is called married. Despite every attempt of the enemy throughout history to destroy the people and strip them from their land, and despite the violence that ensues today on account of a wrongly inspired hatred towards Israel, we know that you still look at them and call them Beulah. You rejoice over them as the bridegroom rejoices over the bride. And may this be the truth that Israel is able to rejoice in, the revelation that God rejoices over her with songs. We pray that the bride of Christ will shine brighter and brighter in Israel, that Messianic Jews and other believers would claim this identity over Israel. We pray that we as the church will do on their behalf what they cannot do. We will stand on truths and contend until they are made evident. And Lord God, we thank you that you are fiercely devoted to Israel because you have chosen to be in covenant with them from the start. And you have not retracted this promise and you don't wane in your faithfulness. We pray for a sense of security and a covering over Israel as the one who is protected and possessed by the one true living God. Let's pray. You call Israel the holy people. They are consecrated. They are people set apart and to be honored. They are made in your image and your likeness. And out of all who are on the face of the earth, they are the ones you chose to be your treasured possession. Truly, you have marked them in a way that you have not marked any other nation or land. We honor Israel for the place they hold in your heart, and we ask for a greater understanding on both our parts and theirs to grasp just how set apart they are. And as you call them holy, you also call them the redeemed of the Lord. So we hold on to this and ask for redemption in Israel, both in the land and in the people. We pray for the justification of Jews, and we ask for believing Jews to grow in number, that they may taste the goodness and grace of Jesus Christ and experience justification by grace through the redeeming blood of Jesus. You say over them, "Behold, your salvation comes." this is a promise that we'll cling to. We want to see existing believers grow in faith in their devotion to you, having undivided hearts and unwavering hope beyond what is seen. We ask for grace for them to fully surrender their hearts in order to be molded into the likeness of Jesus, to willingly and gladly be sanctified for your glory. May the Messianic Jews be bold in claiming and living out the inheritance of the righteous, in walking fully as the holy and redeemed of the Lord. Let's pray. Thank you that you are a God of action and of pursuit. You aren't about having things perfect from the start and sitting back and keeping them that way, but you are all about a story and about a process, one that starts with darkness but ends in light, one that calls for your miraculous works. So we know that you call Israel sought out because you have committed to seeking her out. You call her a city not forsaken because you have not abandoned her. We agree and we declare that Israel is pursued and valued and desired by God. And those who seek after blessing for Israel will be blessed. Lord, we pray that you bring to remembrance the promises you've made to them as a nation and as individuals. Remind them of your faithfulness and that you are indeed for them and not against them. And we pray that Israel would no longer be given up to invasions, to violence or accusations, but rather be covered by your keeping power, God. There is nothing that can come against you and the ones you love. And we know that if in the process Israel's story is already giving you glory, then the end will be all the more glorious. And we thank you that her story isn't over and that you aren't finished with Israel. You're waiting patiently to be gracious to her. You are longing to pour out your compassion upon her. May we as the church stand on this and through prayer and action properly manifest your heart to defend and to love Israel. May she know that she is not fighting alone. Let's pray. Lord, we acknowledge the place that Israel holds in your heart, and we thank you for giving us your word to hold on to. We lift up Israel and we speak identity and life over her. We agree with every name that you call her in Isaiah 62. She is Hephzibah, your delight, your pleasure and crown of beauty. She is Beulah, married, fruitful and rejoiced in. She is holy and redeemed, set apart for your glory and pleasure, bought with the blood of Christ and being saved even now. And she is sought out, a city not forsaken, not forgotten or given over to evil, but pursued and defended as part of a powerful and purposeful love story that you have written. Thank you, Lord, for the greater understanding we get of you by praying for Israel and praying through your word. And we ask for more, and we pray in Jesus' name.
You are the God who saves. say, you are my son, my daughter, don't forget. You put a ring upon my finger, you put a robe upon my bed. You throw your arms around me and say, you are my son, my daughter, don't forget. You put a ring upon my finger, you put a robe upon my bed. You throw your arms around me and say, you are my son, my daughter, don't forget. You put a ring upon my finger, you put a robe upon my bed. You throw your arms around me and say, you are my son, my daughter, don't forget.
Jesus Christ, the blood that was poured out on our behalf, those who are far now draw near, those who are lost are now found. We thank you, God, that every provision that you made for your children, for Gentiles and for Jews, is powerful and effective. We thank you, God, that those that you have predestined, those that you have called, they are yours, they belong to you. You will draw them close to you once again. We lay our trust and our hope in your inability to not deliver on your word. You're a God who has never failed. You're a God who will not start failing now. So we bank our trust, we bank our hope in your word and your promises over us and over your children in Israel. We thank you, God. We love you. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Joining us this morning. We hope that you are blessed to start out your day with worship and with prayer. We have a watch tomorrow evening at 8 p.m. Otherwise, we'll just see you once again next week at 9:30 in the morning. We hope that you have a wonderful rest of the day and that you continue to meditate and stay in his presence all throughout.
Sensitive. I'm like holding it like this and it's like cheek.